Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter origin and evolution, and in that we are studying topic mutation theory of evolution. Now mutation theory of evolution was given by a botanist known as Hugh Doveris, and mutation theory has very correlation with chemical theory. So let's study and find out how. Mutation theory of evolution given by botanist Hugh Doveris is also known as organic theory of evolution, or theory of evolution which gradually changes. Now he proposed this theory by studying a plant species, and this plant was nothing but evening primrose. He also stated that mutation was the law of nature. Now mutations, according to him, could be of different kinds. There could be positive mutations or negative mutation, and all the mutations has no going back or deletion. Mutations try and express their characters, which could be dominant or recessive. Though he didn't know the terms dominant, recessive, homozygous and heterozygous, but he tried to imply mutation as a process which was never going back. It only produced offspring having that particular character. Now, according to theory of mutation, what happens is that it was proposed by Dutch botanist Hugh Doveris in the year 1848 to 1935, and he explains that the process of evolution is a precise organic evolution. He observed that certain striking features of evolution in a plant that he studied, which was an evening primrose. Now this certain characteristics suddenly appeared in midway from nowhere. So basically they were just a gradual change. What mutation theory clearly says is that these new traits, or traits which were formed eventually, are also called as breakthrough Now, they are the traits that are eventually formed in that organism and will show its signs. He also called this phenomena as mutation and changed the forms as mutants, or you can say replicas. The term mutation means sudden changes that were taking place in the genetic material, or you simply say the DNA or chromosomal level of a particular organism. And these changes were always heritable. When I say heritable, it means that it could be passed from one organism to another set of organism. So students, in this part of the chapter, what we try and understand was that how does mutation theory works and what are the different parameters that worked on mutation theory. I hope students, you all are very clear with this concept of mutation theory. Thank you.